Hello, Mr. Nygren here. I'm playing Total War 1942 for Rome Total War and Rome Total War Barbarian Invasion. The only difference with the expansion is that ship battles do not work in the original game, but they do work in the expansion Barbarian Invasion, and they are only for custom battles and historical battles anyway. So I'm playing the Germans in the campaign. And we are currently at the year 1943. The game starts in 1942, as hinted at in the name, and it will go on until 1954. Actually, it's 24 turns per year. All right. So we are. We can't see turn numbers, I believe. But the year is 1943, so we have played more than 24 turns. Probably a few turns during 1943 as well. Right, so we are fighting in the east against the Soviet Union. And we are moving an army towards Portugal, because Portugal invaded Bordeaux here, French area that we are in control of since 1940. And we defeated their army with the troops we sent from the Eastern Front, and then we marched towards their capital, which is over here, but we have to go through the Spanish state territory, because Britain is in control of the water. See, their fleet is pretty huge. They have more fleets too. Spain seems to have a fleet, but they only have a trooper. But Spain is an ally in this game to prevent them from starting a war, but yeah, they are supposed to be neutral, and they are not at war with anyone, I think. Can check to be sure. They have an army here. I don't think they will attack me, but we never know. The Portuguese are trespassing in their land. We had to trespass in order to reach their capital. So we have some Portuguese troops there. So the Spanish state are allied with the Third Reich and the Italian Empire, but they have no enemies currently. So pretty much neutral. The Portuguese have been beaten back. They have a rifle sniper unit here, scout sniper. And another unit there, but they are probably remnants from the beaten army. Right, their capital have 5 units. And we are still moving there. We seem to have already moved this turn. Alright, I'm not sure if we have done the construction and recruitment. I remember that the last thing that happened was that Rommel got beaten and was forced back into Minsk. We had a bug with the tank turret, so they was lost. They were lost. So I believe these tanks might actually look bad now when we fight the battle, unfortunately. So we can't move any of these troops. But we are not constructing. I will go to Berlin, and Berlin in this mod is not a custom settlement. It's a custom settlement, but it's a large city. I believe it's a large city custom settlement, so it has the large city German custom settlement. We have custom settlements for the town, the large town, the city, and the large city. There are no custom settlements for village. Dagovax decided to remove the villages, so all the earliest settlements are towns, actually. And then he's currently working on Berlin, the huge city. So the huge city for Germany is going to be Berlin. But I don't have that in this version, and we can't add it to this campaign. Even if he were to, you know, finish the custom settlement for Berlin tomorrow or today or whatever, we wouldn't have it in this campaign, because it's not save game compatible. I would need to restart the campaign in order to play with the Berlin custom settlement. But we can play another faction later, maybe, and then when we attack Germany's capital, we will fight in the Berlin customs. but in this game, in this version, it will be the large city custom settlement. It's still pretty cool, but it's the same for all the large cities. Like, for example, Leningrad here. Alright, let's take a look at the building construction. So we are constructing a big caserne in Berlin. It's 66% completed. It will take two additional turns before it's complete. And if we go to check the other areas, Hamburg, Oslo, München, they have no buildings to build or construct. We have an aerodrome in Frankfurt being constructed. It's 50% completed. It will take two turns until it's finished. We have a howitzer training ground, 75% completed in Amsterdam. One more turn until it's completed. In Paris we are constructing a howitzer training ground as well. One turn until it's completed. In Bordeaux we have a mortar training ground, the earlier variant. Alright, and it's also completed in one turn. In Minsk we are currently constructing a medium caserne. It takes two turns until it's finished. In Warsaw we can actually construct new buildings. So we have a medium tank factory that we can build here. It will enable us to build the Panzer 1, Panzer 4 and the BMW motorcycle. I believe we can only build the Panzer 1 currently. So it's pretty good. And then we have the mortar training ground that will enable us to build Stokes mortars. We can build a port. It will enable the basic ships of the Hermelin and the Trooper. The civil headquarters will give us public order bonus and spies. We have the aerodrome, will enable us to build a U-88 heavy bomber, as well as the Stukas and Messerschmitts that we already can build. Right, and then we have medium parks. Okay, I believe Warsaw is at the front line, so we will go for the civil headquarters. Will give us public order bonus due to happiness 10%, public order bonus due to law 5%, and ideology, conversion, fascism 10%, and we will be able to recruit spies as well, so we go for that in Warsaw. In Vienna we can't build anything, Prague we can't build anything, same in Stettin, Copenhagen, and we're back in Berlin. Let's take a look at the troops now. So these are the troops we can build currently, and the agents. I kind of want a new diplomat, so I lost the diplomat. It was in Spain. We need a diplomat, so I will recruit a new diplomat in Berlin. In Hamburg, however, I believe we could go for the Messerschmitt 109 fighter plane. Oslo, we will, as usual, recruit the assault riflemen, or assault infantry. In München, I will go for the Messerschmitts. I believe the Stukas are good against tanks and other troops on the ground, but they are bad against fighters, and the Soviet has a lot of fighters. We need fighters to face them. So I will go for the fighters now, as I feel the Soviets are breaking through. So we'll construct Messerschmitt 109 fighters in all the cities that can construct them. It's time. And we don't want the Stukas, because they do very badly against the Soviet planes. You see, the Soviets, they don't have any bombers, they only have fighters. They have two types of fighters. Well, the Germans have a fighter and a bomber here. Later they can get the jet fighters, but that's late in the game. And until they get those, they have a fighter that is still better than the Soviets, but if the Soviets have too many, they will still win, and Stukas have no chance against fighters, so that's why we will rather focus entirely on the fighters to face the Soviet armada of Yak-9 planes and MiG-3s. Right, so Messerschmitt 109s. Be greatly needed to defend the homeland. So we will construct them in Paris as well, and in Rouen. Bordeaux, and in Minsk. Actually, Minsk maybe not, because it was too easy to get those there. We will go for an assault infantry in Minsk, and in Brest, an assault infantry unit. Warsaw. I think we can go for some Messerschmitt 109 fighters there. And assault infantry in Vienna. In Prague, we will also get those Messerschmitt 109 fighters. And in Stettin. In Copenhagen, we will get the assault infantry. And we're back here. How many turns will it take? 2 turns to construct the Messerschmitt. Alright. So we can't move the armies anymore. We've already moved. Let's see if we can move the agents. I may have done that, but I may also not have done that. I don't know. So the agents. We have a spy. We've already moved her. We have another spy in Romania. I like having a view here to know what's going on. Seems the Turkish army is still marching here, but we have areas in control by Bulgaria, areas in control by Hungary, Romania. They're still in control of 2 of their areas at least. Alright, and I don't think Turkey is in control down there, but we will move down. Get a look at what's down there. Ah, so the Italian Empire has reconquered Tirana from Turkey. They have better tanks now, that's why. They have the P-2640. Pretty good tank for the Italians. So they have special attack, fight a nearby enemy, excellent morale, can't hide, fast moving. Description. The P-2640 was an Italian World War II heavy tank. It was armed with a 75mm gun and an 8mm Breda machine gun, plus another optional machine gun in an anti-aircraft mount. The official Italian designation was Carro Armato, Armored Vehicle, P-2640. The designation means P for pesante, Italian heavy. So pesante means heavy. The weight of 26 tons. And the year of adoption, 1940. So it's a tank from 1940, so it's not that good if you compare it with, for example, the Tiger or the T-34-85. It's way worse than those tanks, but it's still much better than the tank they usually have, the Fiat 3000. So physically a medium tank in size, weight, and armor, and armament. It was classified as a heavy tank by the Italian military in reflection of its intended support of smaller tanks on the battlefield. Alright, so the Italians had a lot of World War I light tanks, and as such, their heavy tank, the P-2640, was, compared to other factions, a medium tank, but it was called a heavy tank by the Italians because it was a lot heavier than their light tanks. Alright, then they have a third tank that is even better than this one. That was actually used in the war, but the Germans confiscated all of them in 1943 or something. So they were used by the Germans and not the Italians, but they were Italian tanks. Alright, so they have another tank that they can construct that will arrive later, but this is their second tank. They have the Fiat 3000 light tank, they have this medium tank that they call a heavy tank, and then they have a real heavy tank. Alright, design had started in 1940, but very few had been built by the time Italy signed the armistice with the Allies in September 1943. And the few produced afterwards were used by Germans. Alright. Yeah, the Turks only have Fiat 3000. No, they have the Panzer IVs too, the Fiat 3000s and the Panzer IVs. But the Panzer IVs are about the same as those tanks, probably slightly worse. I'm not sure. They might have better armor too. sure. Could check it, to be honest. This tank has 36. It's experience 3. So, armor, total defense 36. And missile is 24. That's the only values that count for a tank. Take a look at our army here. The other army. Panzer Force. 25 missile, 30 defense. And as I have a short memory sometimes. 24, 36. So they have better defense than our Panzer Force, but they have one weaker missile attack, but they are pretty good, those tanks. And as for the Tigers, they had 51 total defense, so they are a lot better in defense and better in a lot better in attack. They are no match for the Tigers, but they are almost the same as the Panzer Force. Slightly worse, but with better armor. I believe this tank, however, it has the same projectile as the Panzer IV, I think. Alright, so Turkey no longer controls Tirana. Do they control Athens, is the question then? No. Italy has taken Athens as well. We have an entire army here. Messerschmitts. Italian Messerschmitts, same plane as we have, and some Fire 3000s. We also probably have a Jeep bodyguard here, yeah, armored officer's car. Alright, so Italy has taken back Tirana and then gone on and taken Athens from the Turks. So Turkey has been beaten there. They also took an area here from Italy. I'm not sure they still hold it. Yeah, they do, because it is written neutral here. So Turkey is still in control of Palermo. It has lost those two areas to Italy. So Italy has taken pretty much the Greek areas. So the Eastern Roman Empire area there in Greece, but they still are not holding the old capital of Istanbul. So the Italians, they will probably want to conquer Istanbul, but in order to do so they need to go through Bulgaria. So we can't move anymore this time. We probably have a full army inside of that city. Let's move this unit to this city then. And yeah, we will click next turn. And fast forward this. Sovjets did attack our weaker force. We have one unit of weakened riflemen, we have two units of full-sized assault infantry, two units of Stokes mortars with full strength, and we have the attacking army, but they have planes, three units of MiG-3s and three units of riflemen. They will no doubt win that, so we will try to retreat. We succeeded in retreating. Can't fight planes with infantry and mortars. Alright, end of turn report. We are still well in profits. Well off. And then faction announcements. New family member, Maya. Virginia expands. Eval Jaeger, geographer. Plus 15% of movement points. Gives armies the ability to forced march. 10% bonus on tax income. That's good. For his troops. Construction report. In Amsterdam we have a new howitzer training ground. And we have a new howitzer training ground in Paris as well. We have a mortar training ground in Bordeaux. So we are focusing on some artillery there. Recruitment report. Lots of new assault infantry as usual. Different cities, and a new diplomat in Berlin. That was really needed. Let's send the diplomat towards Portugal. We want to force our we want to dictate the peace on our terms. As their army was defeated. I don't want to waste that army. Straight for the capital and ignore those troops. They don't seem to have much of an army there anymore. They sent their entire force to Bordeaux and was crushed. First they won, but we sent more troops. Alright, diplomatic information. Following factions are now at war with each other. The British Commonwealth of Nations and the French Republic. Alright, the British Commonwealth of Nations have declared war on Thailand in the Far East. The French Republic have declared war on Hungary. And I don't believe Hungary has any border with the French Republic too. The following factions have declared a ceasefire. The British Commonwealth of Nations have declared peace with Bulgaria. And Hungary has declared peace with the British Commonwealth of Nations. Alright. And there are British down here and France, French are down here as well, but we have Turkey, a neutral faction, in the way, so we won't see the British or the French moving up here anytime soon. And the Italians are in control of Greece. Let's move back with the spy. So the British and the French will need to first take care of Turkey in order to move this way to reach us. There is a risk they will go by ship, but that doesn't happen too often. It could happen, it's more likely to happen than in Medieval 2, but I don't think it will happen, at least not anytime soon. They have a huge fleet here that is just sitting here doing nothing. Right, have more troops here, move them to Prague. Don't really need to have the spy there. Let's move her up. Get a better idea of how it looks over here in Romania. Turkish army has probably been forced back by the Italians. Our army retreated, let's move them back to the city. So the city garrisons are now stronger in Brest, because the enemy is probably going to attack. We have no planes, and they had planes, that's not good. Here we have an army. Don't really need... the thanks to partaking that battle. We could probably okay. Ah, they didn't reach the front, that was stupid. Three units of planes and three units of riflemen. Alright, let's save the battle. Save the game before the battle. No point letting the tanks partake in the battle. Instead we'll just have planes versus planes and some infantry and mortars. We have the advantage, I believe. in number of planes this time. Dunkirk has fallen. With it has ended the greatest battle of world history. Soldiers, my confidence in you knew no bounds. You have not disappointed me. Adolf Hitler, 15-1940. Right. Start deployment. Start deployment. We only have one unit of riflemen here. Start the battle. Suicide yourself against their troops. Probably their planes will take them out anyway. So the Soviet force is just a minor force, but with the planes, they are of course dangerous. We also have planes arriving from the east. So hopefully there will be a skirmish or a dogfight between the planes here. No point manually commanding the planes. Thought it would be easier to just let the AI control them for now. That's pretty equal anyway. This is just a smaller force after all. So our unit of riflemen got taken out. Hopefully our planes here can do some good against airplanes. What are the other force doing? The mortars. So we have some mortars arriving here. Shooting at their infantry currently. So they are dying like flies, but the real battle will start when the infantry is dead. I prefer fighting even the small battles in real time, because we would probably lose a lot more if we auto-resolved the battle. But this is not a real battle, it was just a few planes versus a few planes. Our planes, by the way, are also consisting of Stukas. That's not good. But we had Stukas. But I hope we have the advantage in fighter planes. We had more planes for sure. The Stukas are weaker in dogfights than their fighters, of course. So they will probably be shot down. The fighters, on the other hand, should be better, but I'm not sure if they are enough to handle their planes. Hopefully they are enough. If I had used the tanks, they would used to be shot at by the planes, and I didn't want to waste them. More important to send in the air force against their air force. It is the balance of power. Percentage enemies killed 76%, allies killed 33%, balance of forces is evenly matched. I believe we will win this. They had too few planes. plane went down. Hard to know from what side. There might be slightly different sound for different planes. I think so. Yeah, we are winning. 81%, 34%. Soviet planes are being shot down from the sky. It was important to send the air force against that force of planes. They would have probably conquered the city alone. Alright, how many percent have we killed? 82%. Let's continue the battle. We need 85%. Ah, we won. Kills 256, including riflemen, of course. And they killed 45 of ours. Only planes, probably. And the detailed statistics. So, one of our messmate units gained 1 experience. Casualties sustained 3, so they lost 3 planes. Casualties inflicted 69, probably including infantry. 32 and 137, certainly including infantry. So the Stokes mortar didn't do any good in the battle. And the riflemen lost all their troops. The assault infantry lost all their troops and inflicted no casualties on the enemy. And these are my troops. I can't see the enemy, alright. Your name is unknown. Your deed is immortal. Tomb of the Unknown Soldier, Moscow. Good that we got rid of that air force. Threatened our army there. Let's move the air force back to the army now. Six units of assault infantry, we don't need that. Remove. Artillery could be moved back to the city. All the planes we could use there. This force, I believe the artillery could be retreated. Rommel himself could be retreated as well. Don't want him to die in Minsk. We will let Ernst Diesel hold the city to the last man. These two infantry units will be sent in to defend. Had no other SS unit here, so we can't merge them. Alright, and the assault North Africa Corps will be symbolic. They will fight the last man too. Alright, we can't move the assault infantry there. The army can move. They have a plane unit, we can win against one of them. Units there. One unit of planes, one unit of infantry. Actually, I will fight the battle on the battle map. Because otherwise, we might lose too much. Fight the battle on the battle map. Otherwise, that would have been a clear auto-resolve.
Ruhm für das Reich! Die Feinde des Reiches werden nicht entkommen!
Start deployment. Ah, it's the general with the PMV motorcycle bodyguard. We have the Tigers. Yeah, as I thought, many of our tanks are without turrets now. It's a shame. Both Panzer 1s and Panzer 4s are affected. Not the Tigers for some reason. Alright. That sucks, but I knew that would happen. Alright, we because yeah, that bug. So let's group all the tanks into one group and all the fighter planes into one group. Alright, start a battle and pause the game. I think we will just send the fighters, take care of the air fighters. So we have a lot of fighters. One unit, but that's still quite a few fighters in a unit. And our fighter planes have been used in prior battles, so they are not at full strength. Full strength is probably 24. Right, so they are half strength or worse. So we have ordered the fighter planes to attack the air fighter planes, and that's all we need to do. Let's sound the horn with the general. I believe that they had horns, but anyway. So the air force is arriving towards their fleet of MiG-3s here. And to speed things up, we will fast forward the balance of power. 25% enemies already killed, so you just need to take out that unit of fighter planes, then we have won this battle. The rifleman unit can't do much. By the way, I need to check the audio. 18%. Alright, it's fine. The dogfighting takes forever, so I need to fast forward, otherwise it will take like an hour before it's done. So the general's dead, Captain Pavel. It was just a captain, no real general. They still have one plane in the air, and there goes the battle. They killed 17, they killed 0. Alright, and here's the detailed statistic. The battle is over! Out some of their smaller forces. I should like to pay the highest tribute for the most gallant fight put up against impossible odds, Admiral Tove, after the sinking of the Bismarck, 27th May 1941. Alright, so we took out that smaller force there. Should we go for Kiev, or should we go towards this unit? I think we will go for Kiev actually. You only have tanks in this army, that wasn't good. We need a spy here. Ah, they have a force here. Stronger force. Alright. He will attack the unit. Can't move anymore this time. I believe they will counterattack the next time, and then it's better if you face Grand Army than attack a city with the tanks. I prefer when I attack cities that they have infantry and planes and not tanks and planes, because we will lose a lot of tanks when we attack the bunkers of the city. Look at this army. There's a lot of MiG-3s and Jack-9 planes, and some infantry. These planes are actually at an advantage. They have more planes than we have. More planes than we do. So that's not good. But the army is a bit away. They might actually attack me the next time. They also have an army outside of the city. That is also dangerous. So we have I guess this army will defend to the last man. Well, we are retreating, the unused pack 40 is there. These two tanks, three tanks, are actually full strength. All of the tanks are full strength. Alright. No, I think we will keep them there. So they are mostly planes. Well, we need a tank to get taken out because they are bagged, so no point having them in the army. Bulgaria is about to attack Bucharest, capital of Romania. They have lots of planes, Messerschmitts and Stuka, same as us. So they have the same air force as we do, Bulgaria, and one unit of riflemen. So their air force is pretty much the same as ours at the moment, which makes them dangerous. Romania, on the other hand, I'm not sure. They also have Messerschmitt 109 fighters. They have the same fighters. And they have some anti-aircraft trucks. And lots of riflemen, assault infantry, scout snipers. Pack 40s, same as ours. It's far from our best. Okay, yeah, pretty equal troops with the Bulgarian faction then. They had a lot of infantry. I think Bulgaria is gonna take Bucharest. Alright, in Berlin we had a new diplomat. I sent that diplomat here. Yeah, they are on their way towards Portugal. Right, so we have moved the army, and this army will stay put. We have agents here, spies. Send one here. Get some information. And the other one. We moved over here. We're starting to have a lot of spies in Europe. In Eastern Europe. Alright. So the Soviets are going to attack Minsk the next time. How far could these planes go? Time, and we need them to defend Minsk, to be honest. Minsk will fall without the planes. Right, let's go to the recruitment. Wait, they have a fleet here. Let's take out that Soviet fleet. And then just move this fleet. Did we lose that many ships? Shit. This means I need a new fleet before I can take on the British. I lost a lot of ships there. I mean, the British have a full full navy. Not here too. Ah. Really dangerous. We need new ships if we are going to challenge the British. So Retinue expands, Gunter Alterbung. Command and control on the battlefield relies on orders getting through. Plus one command. That's good. Okay, let's check the buildings, construction, and recruitment. One turn left until we have the big concern in Berlin. I missed an area there. In Amsterdam we can build something new. Shipwright, we will enable us to get the Prince Eugen and the U-boat. Alright, that's good. This headquarters will enable us to get the spy and public order stuff. Aerodrome, some planes. I think we will go for the SS headquarters actually. Take 4 turns until we have built that in Amsterdam. Paris, SPG training ground. Panzerwaffen small tank factory. I guess we will go for the small tank factory there. Alright, we're back in Berlin. Let's take a look at the recruitment. So we did get a new diplomat in the last turn. During this turn we recruited him. One turn, okay, we will recruit some planes, I guess. Messerschmitt 109 fighter planes. So one turn left until they are completed in Hamburg. Oslo will get another assault infantry unit. As always, one turn left for all the planes we started to construct last time. We have 2 turn construction time. Okay, in Minsk, yeah, we can construct some Messerschmitt 109 fighters there. And in Vienna, some assault infantry. Copenhagen, assault infantry. We were back in Berlin. Alright, and it's the agents. Spy already moved with the spies here. Diplomat moving towards the Reich. Yeah, we'll move him closer to the Reich. And then we have another diplomat over in Africa. So we have Portugal here. Actually, I wanted to speak to the Portuguese. They are pretty much defeated. So we could do this. They have no army, they have 5 units. Show me how, and map information, become protectorate. Alright, done. I don't need Portugal as an enemy now that they have defeated their grand army. They had like 2 units over here, and then they have what? 5 units here, including pretty good ship, pretty good plane, I mean. Wellington, big bomber, but even with that plane they wouldn't stand a chance against this army. But I want to turn this army around and move it towards the east, so that's why I needed Portugal to be out of the war. We've already defeated their army, so. Alliance announced Portugal in the Third Reich. Ceasefire in effect, Portugal the French state. Clan kingdom established, the Third Reich Portugal. Alright, so in essence in 1 turn we would be here, and in 2 turns we would be assaulting the city and take it, and we would be able to take it. So, but we need the army on the eastern front, so. And they were pretty much defeated. It's just a matter of time before they are vanquished, so it's better to make them a vassal. So we have 2 vassals. We have the Hungary faction because they always attacked everyone. And then Portugal. Because they were pretty much defeated. In real life they would have probably sued for peace in this situation. Yeah. Alright, but the Soviets, they are far from defeated, so that war will continue. Alright. And if the Spanish invade, we will need to defeat their army. But on the other hand, they are supposed to be a friendly faction, so we might use the diplomat to keep them friendly. Portuguese, they are supposed to be neutral, so it's kind kind of a what if scenario anyway. Okay, so we had a diplomat in Africa. Let's speak to the British again. When they are so close. Map information and map information. We got some information over here. Alright, we're done there. Let's move on. And we're done. I think next turn we might have some more agents to move. Some spies maybe. Agents. Alright, let's take a look at the strengths of factions overall. Let's check the military strengths. So we were here at start, then we took a dive after all the defeats at the hands of the Soviet Union or the United Soviet Socialist Republics, USSR. Then we got back on our feet, but now we have been declining in strength again and are currently weaker than we were at ever before, but not much weaker, but we are at our weakest currently. Then if we take a look at our allies, the Italian Empire, they are steadily moving upwards, but they are still weaker than our faction. We have Hungary, they are further down. Bulgaria, slightly stronger than Hungary. Romania, they are about the same as Bulgaria in strength. Finland was defeated by the Soviet Union. They took their capital of Helsinki. Then we have Japanese ally. They have really advanced. They are up here, way stronger than our faction. And their ally, Thailand, are down there. Weaker than Romania and Bulgaria. So that's the forces of the Axis. Then we have the neutral Turkey faction. It's still weaker than Romania and Bulgaria, but stronger than Thailand and some of the others. Hungary. Right. Spanish state. Almost as strong as the Italian Empire. Just below the Italian Empire in strength. Alright. Have the French state Vichy, stronger than the Spanish state but weaker than the Italian Empire. Alright, so that's our allies. Then we have the enemy. League of Nations are actually countries stronger than us in military strength. They have no wars, they have South America for themselves and probably can move up here and face the United States as well. Alright, we have India, they are very weak down here, they lack an air force, so that's probably why they are so weak. And the French Republic, they are pretty strong, they are kind of stronger than the Italian Empire, but weaker than us. And Portugal are pretty strong actually. They're still weaker than many of the minor factions. Chinese Republic. The People's Republic of China is very strong, weak, while the Chinese Republic is pretty strong. They seem to be losing against Japan. Right, then we have only the British here then. British Commonwealth of Nations, they are even stronger than the Japanese Empire. Then we have the United States of America, the country is even stronger than the British Commonwealth of Nations. That's because they have probably no wars going on over here, so they can just build and build and build. They have some wars in Africa, I believe. They have already defeated the Germans there and the Italians. Okay, the Soviet Union, shit, even though we have defeated a lot of their armies, look at it, they were here at the start, they were the strongest faction at the start. The others were down here. They have, thanks to our military victories, they have taken a dive. Then they were like plus minus zero situation for a while. And now they are starting to get back on their feet with all the plane spamming. They are about as strong as the British Commonwealth of Nations. The British Commonwealth is slightly stronger. And the United States of America is the strongest faction militarily in the game right now. Overall, on the other hand, we are pretty high, but look at that. The United States are the third strongest overall in the game. The British are the second. The Soviet Union are the strongest, despite all our victories against their armies. Alright, so they are still the strongest in the world. So, and if we are going to check the great five or top five factions in the game, so Germany is still one of the great. Okay, so Germany is probably number five. Yes, the weakest of the five. And then we have Japan, the fourth strongest. After that we have the United States being the third strongest in the world. The British Commonwealth of Nations are slightly stronger and are the second strongest faction in the world, and the United Soviet Socialist Republics, Soviet Union, are the strongest faction in the world currently. Yeah, the war isn't going too well for Germany, even though we are focusing entirely on the Soviet Union. Even though we had to send an army to take care of Portugal, but now we will be able to focus on Soviet again. Okay, let's end the turn. So they did attack Minsk. I knew they would attack Minsk or the army. They did attack the city. So the first army, four units of MiG-3s that haven't been in battle before. We have 4 units of Messerschmitt 109 fighters, but they have been in battle, so they are weak and they have fewer numbers of planes. Okay, and then an entire army to reinforce that. They have 4 units, 5 units of riflemen compared to our 1 unit of riflemen. And they have 1 unit of assault infantry. Instead we have 2-3. We have 4 units of assault infantry and 1 unit of riflemen instead. So we have the upper hand when it comes to the infantry. As for the tanks, they have a T-34. We have like 3 units of Panzer 1s and 2 units of Panzer 4s. So we have the upper hand in tanks as well. And we have a Stokes mortar. They have a Stokes mortar. We are slightly stronger. We have more crewmen. They have 4 crewmen, we have 17. Then they have planes, and they have the advantage in planes. But we have the city with the bunkers, so, and we have the general's bodyguard. Alright, so they have the advantage in the air. They have air superiority, but we have everything else, pretty much. So it will be an interesting battle. We might lose. Okay. So, fight the battle on the battle map. The first real battle during this continued playthrough. Probably the fourth battle of Minsk or something. Second defensive battle where we are defending. We should have more custom buildings this time. There are lots of houses too. Large town, here's the large town. Public order building. mostly houses, of course. Here we have the airstrip. Yeah, an airstrip here. Some mess with 109 fighter planes. Ready to take off there. Should have some more custom buildings, I think. Like infantry buildings or something. Maybe they are somewhere in between the ordinary houses. Some old vanilla buildings there. Here we have the civil headquarters. So this is a civil headquarters building. Damage 13%. We can see the damage on the inside. Some damage on the outside as well. Catholic Church, it's probably vanilla. Here we have the medium concern. So that's the medium concern. Alright. So we are placing the general's bodyguard in the center. And loose formation. And so for the rest, let's group them and loose formation and place them under AI control and with the guard mode on. Guard mode on and then AI control. Start the battle. So these are the remnants of the army that we had here. They should be pretty strong. I wonder if the tanks are bugged or not. Most of them seem to be intact. So the Soviet Union has air superiority in the battle. The bug didn't happen to these tanks that were at full strength, only to the tanks that had less than 24 units. So I believe I could fix the buggy tanks by making them 24 from the start. Problem is, there is no such trainer or cheat program to force them to be 24 at the beginning of each turn. So the Soviet Union are also sending in their infantry. Some T-34s. It's a pretty cool view looking at it from this. The bunkers did take out some of their tanks and planes. Ram there. Here they have their mortar. Very few crewmen. So it only counted as one mortar. Four crewmen. They are already at the center. Our leader is dead. Ernst Dissel died. This time they did manage to take out the leader. Not good. Let's move the troops to the center. We don't want them to win with the time. Actually, I need to hurry up. Take the center, otherwise the city is lost, even though the army is not defeated. We still have our tanks here. And the infantry. It would be cheating if they won with the timer. Now they have a T-34 over here. Alright, building lost, building captured, building lost, building captured, building captured. For now it looks good. It doesn't look too good in the balance of power meter. Percentage enemies killed 18%. Percentage enemies... percentage allies killed 18%. Percentage enemies killed 16%. Yeah, they had their superiority, so that's why the battle isn't going too well here. We needed to mass our remaining troops at the center to defend, otherwise they would have won by the timer. I don't think our tanks and infantry can do much else than hold the center for a short period of time. In order to win, our messmates will need to do well in the battle, and the Stukas. Building lost, building lost, building captured, building captured, building lost, building lost. Right. Building captured. Building lost. Alright, going back and forth here. Yeah, but they are broke. They are pouring in more troops there. Zoom in on the minimap. Wavering troops there. The dogfights are still going on in there. Outside of the city. If we win, it will be tanks to the messmate planes. The other troops, they can just buy some time for the planes. Alright, building captured, building lost, building lost, building captured, building captured, building lost. They're gonna be using pistols now, their melee weapon. Soviet infantry is reloading their rifles, preparing to fire. They are winded, shaken. tower. Defeat is a distinct possibility. 51% allies killed, 41% enemies killed. Their riflemen are broken here. Some of our riflemen are broken as well. That was theirs too. Ah, here we have the North Africa Assault Corps. The only such unit we have currently. We can't get any new unless we go to Africa. So they are a unique unit, that's why I didn't disband them. They are a remnant of Erwin Rommel's African Corps army. Fortunately, they are attacked by plane now. Alright. So they attacked from two fronts during this battle. Panzers are not totally worthless, they are still pretty good. They have probably taken out a few of their tanks and scared away their infantry at the center. But at the end of the day, we wouldn't have stood a chance without our planes. Assault corps have reached the center. There are still five. There are still five of them. The USSR infantry are retreating. Their airplanes are still in the air. So I think probably the battle will be lost this time. 61% allies killed, 47% enemies killed. Currently the building is counting as lost. Now it's counted as captured again because we took back the center. Minsk is probably lost. Their mortar has taken out some of our buildings. Some houses have been leveled to the ground. That mortar. Cool view in the custom settlement. Looks pretty huge. Seem to be routing all their infantry at least. I think we will fast forward, I don't have time to wait on the dogfighting to be over, it could take forever. So there are some infantry still in the center. we got some fog. Oh, what is it? Fog of war. Still have quite a few planes in the air. Here we have a tank, a Panzer I. The battle isn't lost. Enemy General Fallen, Captain Nikolai, but it's just a Captain Nikolai. Nikolai, something like that. Alright. We lost all our troops soon. All our infantry is counted as lost. Yeah, they are all dead now. Probably taken out by their planes or something, yeah, in the center. The tanks are almost all taken out and they were full-sized from the start. Alright. Move to the center before they win. Good. Panzer I managed to retake the center in time. I got taken out. Here is the last one. Here. Let's move it to the center as well. Doesn't really matter if it's taken out. There it is. And if it's taken out, then we will just wait until the battle in the sky has been resolved. All the other units will be out by that point. We only have this tank unit left now. Have a routing unit as well, Panzer IV, but you can't control it, it's broken. So it's here. Then we have some planes fighting in the sky here. Let's move all the planes to the center. Can't let them win by the timer. They will have to take out every single plane from the sky. Still had quite a few planes in the air. They have now all moved towards the center there. Soviet Union has a few planes on the outskirts of the city. Most of our planes are now at the center. Balance of power, 78% allies killed, 67% enemies killed, defeat is almost a certain there. Still pretty equal, in percentage at least. Back to the center, please. Alright, we are clearly losing this battle. All the planes will be shot down. We'll probably take the center without killing the final tank, too. Very few left. The Messerschmitt 109 fighters. Look at the carnage here. Alright. unit left of fighter planes. There is the final plane, we have only one left. Move to center. Alright, so one plane left. They have quite a few left. Back out of the city. That's not good. Move back to the center. Alright. Just a matter of time before the last one of the Messerschmitt 109 fighter planes have been shot out of the sky. Minsk is lost. Alright. 68% enemies killed, 81% allies killed. Forever. And it's over! Clear defeat. So our army under Ernst Dissel had 409 men, killed 475, that's very good. Men remaining 69, but all of them will be dead because we lost the city. Enemy armies Captain Jorgi and Captain Nikolai had 599 men and 97 men respectively. 97 planes probably killed 94, very good, and then the others killed only 237. Alright, 82 and 180 remaining respectively. Alright, and our army statistics. As you can see, the planes did a good job at killing enemies. And the one rifleman unit killed 2 units. Then I believe the planes mostly. Panzer 4 killed 13 enemies, Panzer 1 killed 7, Panzer 4 killed 19. The Panzers were totally worthless. Panzer 1 killed 12, another one killed 0. Alright. And the battle is over and Minsk has been lost to the Soviets. He attacked again. Our army here. They seem to have the advantage. Yeah, they have total air superiority here. Shit. We had a lot of panzers. Oh yeah. Guess we will retreat, but we will retreat in the battle. Fight the battle on the battle map. You are doomed. You have already cut rations by a half, but your prestige and honor have been upheld. General Homma, speaking of General MacArthur, January 1942. Start deployment. Not the best weather conditions. They have total advantage in this battle. A lot of our tanks are ugly. They could probably be wasted, but they might do better somewhere else. Okay, I move them back like this. It's an entire army. Tanks. I believe to remove the bug we need to have them in full strength, like for example 24, 24, 24, then they will be full strength and look good. I will try that. This means we will need to merge them and we will probably lose half of them, but that's fine. At least we will get rid of the bugged tanks. But it looks pretty cool when they are in a formation like this. Yeah. Frame, some of them are broken. Alright, start the battle and retreat. If we retreat on the strat map, there is a high risk that the enemy will just hunt us down and attack again, and then we can't retreat. If we attack in the battle, we will certainly retreat to a safe location, another settlement, etc. So it's better to retreat in battle if we really want to preserve the army. Has some BMW motorcycles, probably the bodyguard. Yeah, the bodyguard, I saw the general there. And some tigers here as well. Set it to save the army. And we have fled. They have a lot of planes. Alright. War declared on ally by the Italian Empire on Bulgaria. Bulgaria has always been friendly to us. I won't agree with the Italian Empire declaring war on them. War declared on ally by Japanese Empire on Portugal. Yeah, I will choose the Japanese Empire. Alright, end of turn report. Faction announcements. Construction report. So in Berlin we have a big concern, Frankfurt we have an aerodrome, and in Minsk we have a medium concern. Recruitment report. In Frankfurt we have a new Messerschmitt 109 fighter plane, and we have a new Messerschmitt in München, Hamburg, Rouen, Amsterdam, Paris, Brussels, Prague, Budapest, Warsaw, and Stettin. That's very good. For the defense, and then of course we have some massive of the infantry in Vienna, in Copenhagen, in Oslo. Yeah. Diplomatic information: the following factions are now at war with each other. The Japanese Empire declared war on Portugal, and we took the side of the Japanese Empire. The British Commonwealth of Nations declared war on Hungary and Bulgaria. The following factions have broken their alliances: the Bulgaria and Romania. Following factions have declared a ceasefire. The Japanese Empire has declared a ceasefire with the British Commonwealth of Nations. Alliance in tatters, the Italian Empire and the Third Reich, because we took the side of Bulgaria over the Italian Empire. Alliance in tatters, Portugal and the Third Reich. In history, in 1943, the Italians signed a peace with the Allies. and betrayed the Reich, so the Reich had to invade it, because it would be kind of historically correct to attack Italy by this point. But I don't really want that if I can avoid it. So the army escaped to Romanian lands. We have more Soviet troops here. Alright, let's move. Army. One full unit there of tanks. I want them to not be bugged. That's why I'm combining them like this. See if that helps. Alright. Planes aren't bugged anyway, but at least now maybe the tanks will look good. I'm not sure about the 21, but the 24 ones should hopefully look better now. Even though we have less tanks. You can see the others as defeated. Or blown up when they were on the ground without actually taking part in a battle. Maybe a Soviet plane came by and bombed them when they were standing on the ground or something. Anyway, we have some pack 40s here. Let's move them to Brest. And this assault infantry will also move to Brest. Make ready to defend. Rommel is retreating back towards Berlin. A diplomat here. The Soviets took back Minsk. They're now threatening the Polish town of Brest instead. Here we have no air power. We have a Messerschmitt here that we can move to Brest. It will certainly be needed. It's in full strength too. We need a general there. Alfred Goebbels will be sent there to defend Brest. This army can't move anymore this time. We will try to move the army up towards Brest or Warsaw. Diplomat here that we want to move. Could speak to the French again. Because we could get some updated map information there.
On the listed offer and demand items to create a left click on an item in the proposal to remove it. A balanced or very generous treat.
Nothing new, I see. At least I don't think there was much of a new map there. Any news on the map. So the Turkish army has moved back to Istanbul, to the region of Istanbul there. We have some diplomat, spy here. Had a diplomat over here too. We need to move it down towards Italy. Send a tank unit to Warsaw. And the plane unit to Warsaw as well. Actually, I need to gather an army. Tanks. Could use a general too. And to use one as the infantry. Don't need more infantry in the army. That's the front towards the Italians. I need a plane there, probably. Can save the Stuka as defensive. As a defensive plane unit, the others will be sent to the army. Some tanks and some planes there. Save the Stuka, send the Messerschmitt 109 fighters. Alright, so we have 5 units of tanks. Nine plane units. We don't need Stukas. That's fine. Have an army over here. So we are not at we do not have peace with Portugal anymore. Have another diplomat over here. Let's move him to Portugal. I think they might actually attack again if we move away from here. Build up and attack again. Let's attack Portugal after all. So we can attack immediately. I can't really see a unit that can attack walls, so. Unless the tanks can do that. Maybe they can, because elephants can in the vanilla Rome Total War game. So maybe the tanks can just crush the wall or gate, but I don't know. There are 2 Wellington bombers here. The Vickers Wellington is a British twin-engine long-range medium bomber. It was designed during the mid-1930s and at Brooklands in Weybridge, Surrey, led by Vickers Armstrong's chief designer Red Pearson. A key feature of the aircraft is its geodetic airframe fuselage structure, which was principally designed by Burns Wallis. Development had been started in response to Air Ministry specification B932, which was issued in the middle of 1932. This specification called for a twin-engine day bomber capable of delivering higher performance than any previous design. Other aircraft developed to the same specification include the Armstrong Whitworth-Whitley and the Handley Page Hampton during the development process. Performance requirements, such as for the tire weight, changed substantially, and the engine used was not the one originally intended. Alright, they have some dangerous planes there, dangerous bombers. We'll wait one turn with the attack. So we lost Minsk. Now the front has moved to Brest. Still have the army under Gunter Alterbang that fled the last battle, but they will still probably attack with this plane army. And I don't think Brest will be able to hold against that with one unit of planes, to be honest. Let's move that plane to Warsaw instead. And the artillery to Warsaw. move this artillery the next time. Move the assault infantry there as well. Change my mind, the general will move to Warsaw. Brest will probably fall. We have this army that could try to stop the army, but it will need some more planes before it can handle that army. Okay, let's go to the construction. We have the ship to the fleet. Let's move it over here. And then we can look at the construction. SPG training ground. Enable us to build a Stokes mortar, pack 40, vest, pummel, and then the aircraft truck. Right, we have the vest but not the hummel. Civil headquarters, spy, aerodrome, U88. I will do the SPG training ground then. No, it's 6 turns. 3 turns, 3 turns, 4 turns. Alright, let's go for the civil headquarters. Berlin. And we're back in Berlin. Let's take a look at the recruitment and construction. In Hamburg, we will of course go for a Messerschmitt plane. Then in Oslo, we could get some more SLT infantry. München will get Messerschmitt 109 fighters. Frankfurt also Messerschmitt 109 fighters. Amsterdam too. And in Brussels. Paris. In Rouen. And in Bordeaux. In Brest we will get an assault infantry unit. In Warsaw we could go for the Messerschmitts. It will surely be needed there. In Vienna we have assault infantry. And in Prague we'll also construct some SLT infantry, some Messerschmitt 109 fighter planes. Stettin as well. And SLT infantry in Copenhagen. So there'll be a lot of focus on planes going forward. War, yeah. Declare war on Portugal. Because otherwise they will build up their forces and attack again. We need to move our agents. Have an army over here. Grand army. And there's Grigory Abramashvili. Abramashvili. Should have more spies. Let's go here. Take a look. Save armies along this entire front. Riga is still held by the rebels. Could keep that spy over there. Move this one up a bit. We are done. We can't fight any more battles in the east. And the army in the east is besieging Lisboa, capital of Portugal. End turn. we are attacked. Portugal decided to sally out. Shit, they only had planes. Hurricane fighter plane. They are dangerous. At full strength, and they have their bombers. But I think we will be able to win. Bombers are usually worse than the fighters, so. I will try to avoid using most of the army and only use the planes against Portugal. You think of the lives which would have been lost in an invasion of Japan's main islands. A staggering number of Americans, but millions more of Japanese, and you thank God for the atomic bomb. Command of one marine in the Pacific. You think of the lives which would have been lost in an invasion of Japan's mainland islands. Right. So they are moving out. We didn't get to prepare our army, of course. Their planes are already coming at us. So this group retreat. We will retreat all our bad troops. The rest will stay and fight. Retreat the general and the infantry. Here comes their great bombers. New York. These planes. Heavy bomber planes of Portugal. They have bought from the British. They also had some fighter planes that are also from Britain, and better than ours. So this is the capital, a large a city, I believe. High kings, hail, still vanilla. Pretty cool city. They have ancient walls protecting it. I believe the worst wall, at least, in the game, with a machine gun on top of the towers. The fighter planes are the same. The game. I need the tanks to suicide themselves. We have no use for the tanks. They are bugged anyway. And then we can let the Fed mostly bombers, but guess our bombers can attack their bombers. We'll do that. We'll attack with the Stuka tactical bombers. And then our fighters. We'll go in and take care of the fighter planes inside the Hurricanes. We'll send one of them against the Wellington. Two against their unit inside of the city. So this will be an entirely focused in on the air battle. We lost a lot of our tactical bombers against their bombers. Guess their bombers are better than ours. Took down some of their bombers too. our panzers. Now they sent in their Hurricane fighter planes. It took out a lot of their giant bombers too. Not good, I wanted to use those planes in the east. I will only have the infantry and the general left. Which isn't good. Building lost. That tank will probably be taken out by their heavy bombers. Panzer 1. Well, this battle. Let's pause. Stukas, so they have 37 missile attack, defense 16. Well, the airplanes. Wellington have 36 missile attack and 32 defense. Yeah, they are a lot better than our tactical bombers, but I thought our Messerschmitts would do better. Probably because their Hurricanes are better than our Messerschmitts and they were at full strength. While ours had been in battle before, that's why they lost. Here is the tank. There. So the Panzer 1 tank just got taken out. We only have a Stuka tactical bomber left. Seems to be stuck. Not good. Let's fast forward, it's stuck. Can't move. Wonder how it got stuck there. It can't move out of there, unfortunately. Now it can move, finally. It will probably be taken out soon. Yeah. Alright, we lost the battle. Had 19 kills, they had 74 kills. Those giant planes weren't bad. I guess we will move the rest of the army back towards Berlin. And the eastern front. War declared by Romania on Bulgaria. I won't take the attacker's side. Got a new general too. We have one ship left. Still better than no ship. So the Saki troops will move back towards Germany. End of turn report. Profits are still good. Faction announcements. Construction complete and Warsaw have a civil headquarters, which is good for the public order in the city. Recruitment report. Berlin, we have a new Messerschmitt 109 fighter. Then we have a lot of SLD infantry in Vienna, Copenhagen, Oslo, and Brest. diplomatic information. Fallen factions are now at war with each other. Romania have declared war on Bulgaria, as we saw. The French state Vichy has declared war on Portugal, which is good for us. Fallen factions have declared ceasefire in the Japanese Empire and the British Commonwealth of Nations. Alliance and Tatars, Romania and Third Reich, yeah. Move the diplomat towards Portugal. No Soviet troops have crossed the border yet. But they have taken Riga from the rebels. So they focused on the rebels. They have taken Riga. And are now in control of the Baltic states. Move this army towards Warsaw. One infantry unit and army. To handle rams. I wonder where they will strike next. They have taken Riga and now has a united front here. Let's strike against Romania maybe. Or against us. Probably against us. So Brest is very, very weak. I have a new general here, Gerd von Rundstedt. And Alfred Goebbels. Okay. Let's move one general to Brest, I think. Maybe. Yeah, I think we'll move a general there to defend. The infantry can move to Brest too. Need a stronger front there. Some artillery could be good too to defend. Back in Berlin. Send this plane to the army too. The infantry in Stettin and in the other areas there. Need a plane unit in Vienna to scare off the Italians. Rommel could move to Hamburg. Could have a general there. Let's move Felix Battle to Amsterdam. So we do not have a lot of planes. Need a plane towards Vichy, France too, a little bit there. Duke attacked a bomber could be moved into Staden. Two new fighter planes here in Paris. One of them is needed to guard against Vichy France. Man. Maybe I will move it to. I think Vichy France can be handled through diplomats. So three more planes. Two slots. Let's move in another plane there. Stuka, tactical bomber. And some more planes. Oh. Probably lost the plane by doing that. All right.
Mein Kaiser.
Diplomat here in Africa can move on towards their goal. Enemy settlements. An enemy has taken over this area of Tripoli. Maybe it's America. I'm not sure. So we are not recruiting. Let's check the construction then. I probably haven't done it this turn. Shit, in Sweden the weather became very warm all of a sudden. I didn't think it was any good weather today. I had planned to go out and do some stuff, but the weather sucked. But now the clock is like 19:00 almost, and the weather is very hot all of a sudden. I wish it had been earlier today, then I would have gone out and done some stuff. But we'll have to wait until tomorrow, and hopefully it will be the same weather tomorrow. Anyway, in Warsaw we will go for the mortar training ground. Alright, back in Berlin. Now it's the construction. Let's construct another Messerschmitt. Maybe not. Maybe we'll focus on some tanks. Let's construct another Tiger One tank and a Panzer One. No, we are still constructing Messerschmitts there. Oslo will go for the assault infantry. Ah, I missed one there. Vienna will go for assault infantry. And in Copenhagen as well. We're back in Berlin. Right. Next turn soon. I just want to move the diplomats in case I haven't done so. Have a diplomat here. Let's speak to the Italians.
Left click on the listed offer and demand items to create a
map information.
Left click on an item in the proposal to remove it. A balanced or very generous treaty proposal is likely to be accepted.
And we have some map information here. So this is still a enemy, it says. I'm not sure. Bulgaria has taken Istanbul. Allied settlement. Yeah, they have taken Istanbul from Turkey. So Turkey has started to be in trouble because they don't have that good units in the game. Bulgaria seems to have the stronger army in terms of quality of units. This late in the campaign at least. Turkey still holds mainland Turkey. Okay. Let's move the spy down here so I can get some idea about what's happening. Okay. Istanbul. Portugal has an army in Turkey. Probably came from Africa or something. Can't blame Italy for attacking Bulgaria. I mean, they want Istanbul probably. So Hungary, enemies, yeah, British Commonwealth, United States of America, French Republic, League of Nations. They're allied with Turkey and with us. They're our vassal. Alright, and then Japanese Empire. Similar enemies as before at the start of the game. Spanish state has no enemies. French state Vichy. Similar enemies as in the start of the game, plus Portugal. Bulgaria, they are at war with the Italian Empire now. Romania, at war with Bulgaria, allied with the Italian Empire. Need to become allied with them again.
Mein Kaiser. Im Osten. Heute geht es nicht mehr weiter.
Okay. Didn't we have any diplomat over here? You already moved. Turkey is getting beaten back. Neutrally, an enemy has taken this area, Heracleion, from Turkey, probably Britain. This area is probably still held by Turkey. They took it by themselves. We gave them Heracleion and Athens, and they lost those. They also took Tirana, but they lost it now, and they lost one of their starting areas, Istanbul. So the war isn't going Turkey's way. Alright, next turn. Forgot about the fleet. Rioting. In Brest. We can't construct any buildings. I guess they have a panic. Soviet Union is marching on them now. Alright. See here, we will army to Warsaw. So they are attacking on two fronts, but they are also entering this area from this side. There are fleets over here. Huge fleet. Moskva and the Orlen. Moskva, which is Moscow in Russian and in Swedish. Alright, rioting. End of turn report. City grows, Berlin. So you can upgrade the city probably. It's a large city I wouldn't want to upgrade. Alright, construction complete, Paris. Small tank factory in Paris. Recruitment report. We have new Messerschmitt planes. Frankfurt, München and Hamburg. So let's see, Rouen, Amsterdam, Paris, Brussels, Prague, Bordeaux, Warsaw and Stettin. Diplomatic information. Following factions have declared their allies, the Chinese Republic and the United Soviet Socialist Republics. And the following factions are now at war with each other, British Commonwealth of Nations and Japanese Empire. Okay. You're far from defeated. Let's send out this plane to you. And one of these. And move this army up. Pretty strong army. This army. Fuck, I moved it too far. Can't attack this time. Move that plane to the army as well. Full army there now. Full sized army. Full sized army. Okay. Spy could be moved back here. All right, we'll keep the spy there. So you know what is going on over here. Romania has some troops in Tirana. They're still quite strong there. Normander Razvan Vasilevskiy, family member. They are quite far from their borders. All the way into Italy. They are allied to Italy, which means they have probably been defeated by Bulgaria and forced back into Italy. A spy here as well. Can let her stay there. Tanks in this army. MS1s and T-34s. General Vladimir Khrushchev. Vladimir Khrushchev. Khrushchev. All right. Have a diplomat here. We send it towards Romania.
Left click on the listed offer and demand items to create a proposal.
Map information. Thank you. We don't need an alliance currently.
Very generous treaty proposal.
Italy has really taken the eastern part of the empire, they just need Istanbul. And they have all of Greece and the other areas over here. The United States is over here, they've taken Tripoli. Here we have a small force, T1 Cunninghams, the reverse tank, World War I tank, 1930s tank, and the Corsair fighter plane, pretty good. Okay, so the United States have taken Tripoli. Speak to them. Left click on the listed offer and demand items to create a map information. Thank you. Proposal to remove
it. A balanced or very generous treaty proposal is lucky.
Okay, so we got the map information from the United States of America. Have their information on the map now. They own these regions. North America, Alaska. But the United Nations are still holding areas all the way up here. US have an area here. Panama. So they have a few areas in Africa. Tripoli. Benghazi. And Alger. And they have Casablanca and Marrakesh. Right, so five areas in Africa. And some areas over here. They also have Iceland up here. Reykjavik. Should have some ISILs over here as well. Britain and the United States are controlling these ISILs. Australia. This ISIL, Mataram, cities Mataram. Have an area here and here. Batava. Palembang. Japan is controlling this area too. Singapore has fallen to Japan. Britain has taken a lot of areas inside of Thailand. India is still around. Japan is still around. Portugal has one area over here. The Chinese Republic. Alright. We need to speak to Japan, but they are far away. I don't believe Thailand has a lot of areas left, but we would like to speak to them as well. Problem is we don't have a navy strong enough to survive a journey over there. If I reach the borderlands over here, then I could use the move character sheet and end up somewhere in the Soviet Union here, because this area and this area is connected by land, but then I need to go here first. The city of Sverdlovsk, large city. But in order to get there, I need to first defeat the Soviet Union. And the war isn't going our way. We are currently being invaded on two fronts in Poland. All of Poland is being invaded currently. And after that, they are in Germany. So yeah, the war isn't really going our way currently. Okay, let's continue. You can't move anymore. Thanks to our planes, we will probably be able to beat them back. This army might be defeated, I'm not sure. Well, this army is supposed to be strong enough to defeat some of their armies, maybe. Okay. Some planes here.
Unsere heutige Reise ist beendet, Kaiser. Kaiser? Mein Kaiser? Ja, mein Kaiser? Ja.
Move some planes into Berlin there. Four fighters inside of Berlin. Five fighters. I don't fighter plane in Prague. Maybe we do. It's a border area, probably. Let's keep it there for now, at least. Right, we have an army here, we can probably move. Let's move him back to Bordax. So we entered Bordax with that army. Under George Becker. Jörg Becker. Alright. Guess it will defend for now. Yeah, I'm being a little off today. Anyway, my English is kind of bad from time to time. It's a bit better in some videos and worse in others, because sometimes I'm just, I don't know. I just speak more fluently some days, and others I just don't. I don't know why. Anyway, I probably need to go and eat something soon. But let's take a look at the recruitment and construction. We are still constructing a civil headquarters in Berlin, and it will be finished in one turn. And in Paris, could construct SPG's training grounds, but I will go for the civil headquarters there as well. And we're back in Berlin. As for the construction, we are constructing a Tiger 1 in Berlin currently. We will go for Hamburg. We could actually go for a Messerschmitt 109 fighter. Oslo, as usual, will recruit the assault infantry. München, some Messerschmitt 109 fighters. Frankfurt will go for some shit. We have the U-88 heavy bombers, special attack bonus versus planes and vehicles, can swim, frighten nearby enemy, excellent morale, can't hide. Junkers U-88 was a German World War II Luftwaffe, twin engine, multiple combat aircraft. Junkers Flugzeug und Motorentwerk, IFM, designed a plane in the mid-1930s as a so-called Schnell bomber, fast bomber, that would be too fast for fighters of its era to intercept. It suffered from a number of technical problems during its development and early operational periods, but became one of the most versatile combat aircraft of the war. Like a number of other Luftwaffe bombers, it served as a bomber, dive bomber, night fighter, torpedo bomber, reconnaissance aircraft, heavy fighter, and at the end of the war as a flying bomb. Cool. We had some of these in the beginning of the campaign. Let's build some more of these. Alright, in Amsterdam, we will continue with the Messerschmitt 109 fighters. I believe those big planes could be actually good against fighters, so we'll go for some of them. Messerschmitt in Paris, and in Rouen as well. I clicked the wrong button there. Okay, Bordax. Go for Messerschmitt 109 fighters. Okay, and in Warsaw, some Messerschmitts. We have some assault infantry. And in Prague some Messerschmitts as well. Soviets are throwing planes at us. And our smaller allies also have a lot of planes in their armies, so... Okay, Stettin, Messerschmitts, Copenhagen Assault Infantry. And we're done here. Next turn. Portugal has sent a diplomat. No, we sent a diplomat to Portugal. Good.
Left click on the listed offer and demand items to create a proposal. Left click on an item in the proposal to remove it. A balanced or very generous treaty proposal.
They won the battle, so I guess we can't demand them to be a protectorate. But we will demand map information. Alright, that's all we want from you. They were too strong in their capital. The Soviet Union is attacking Brest now. We only had 4 units of riflemen there. Jesus Christ. Grigory Abramasvili and Konstantin Avdeyev have attacked, and they have lots of planes and tanks and other stuff. And the second army has some tanks, MS-1 tanks, and T-34s, and a Yak-9 plane. I guess this is over already. We will fight the battle on the battle map just for fun. Fight the battle on the battle map. I want to see the army when it takes the city. I should have placed the army next to the city, but unfortunately I clicked the wrong spot, so it ended up too far away to aid the city in the battle. That sucks for us. Alright, we're pretty much doomed. Guard mode, loose formation, and that's it. Start the battle. So this is the army that is invading Brest, Polish town. Bunkers are shooting at them, but that won't help. The tanks have already passed the bunkers and the planes too.
Verdammt! Unsere Mauern wurden eingenommen.
Our infantry is being slaughtered at the center. Even if we had been able to reinforce the army, the garrison in the city, the army would probably have lost. Lost the captain, building is lost. Their infantry is entering the city. Small concern here. And they have won. Raised the banner. The Soviet Union at the center there. Clear defeat. Killed 9 enemies too. Probably the bunkers. Half of Poland was just lost. Shame the army couldn't reinforce the city. Now they are attacking the army. This force. We have the upper hand, actually. same smaller army and another bigger army. They left a few of their troops in the city. We'll fight this battle. Maybe they will be able to retake the city or town. This is not the end, it's not even the beginning of the end, but it is perhaps the end of the beginning. Winston Churchill, 10th November 1942.
Für die Ehre, für das Reich. Ihnen nach, Männer, für das Reich.
Start deployment. Look at the tanks now, if they have any bug tanks. They look fine, so I guess if we merge the tanks and make sure all the tanks have full size, they will look good. That's very good. No problem is the AI will not have full size tanks, so they will still be bugged then. I guess if you play the game and you construct tanks, then they will look good, and if you lose battles and you have less than 24 tanks, they will still continue to look good until you exit the game or until you load a save game. When you load a save game, however, all the tanks that have less than 24 men will be without a turret. But if you merge them, they will get a new turret, but then you will lose a few of the tanks. Because when you merge a unit, you will probably use... if you have two units, like for example with 12 in number in each, then you will lose one in order to get a full unit of 24 tanks, but the tanks in each unit is not, I believe it's like one unit of tanks is like 5 tanks, but 24 human soldiers, if you will. So when you merge two units of tanks that are 12, you will get the maximum number of soldiers, which is 24. Then that will fix the turret issue, but then you will lose probably one unit in exchange for you will lose if you merge them, you will lose one unit out of two, so you lose 5 tanks out of 10 tanks, but all of those 5 that you get will look good, while the 5 that you lose will have been probably bugged otherwise. So I guess what I'm saying is if you load a save game, you will get bug tanks without turrets, but you can fix that by merging the tanks, but then you will lose half your tank units, because when you merge them, you lose one unit in exchange for a full unit, and one unit consists of 5 tanks. So if you merge 5 tanks with 5 other tanks and all of them have bugged turrets, then I believe one bugged unit may have like 2 tanks without turrets and 3 that have turrets, or the opposite. In some cases, maybe even all of them are without turrets, but when you merge them so they have 24 soldiers in each, then they will look good again. So it's possible to cheat in order to make tanks look good after you load the save game. Just cheat so all the tank units are at full size and it will look good again. Or you need to play until you have merged them so they are back at full size. However, for the AI it will be harder, because you can't really cheat for the AI or merge the AI tanks. Okay, so we have lots of Panzer I's here. Two units of Panzer I's, we have one unit of Tiger I's, and we have 5 units of Panzer IVs actually. All of them looked well. All of them looked good. And then we have some Pack 40s here. And we have a lot of planes in this battle. units weren't at full strength. I see that now. So let's see here, we will group the tanks into one unit and the planes into another unit. But not the Stukas, they will be on their own. Artillery could be one unit. Alright. Let's move the general way back. We don't need assault infantry there either. They are for the ram roll. Okay, start the battle. And it's time to manually order them around. Okay, so they had quite a few infantry units in this battle as well. And some tanks. Let's place the artillery, the pack 40s at enable fire at will. They will fire randomly at the enemy. And we will send the Panzer Ones against their riflemen. So we will take out their riflemen there. Send some Panzer Force against their riflemen too. Another unit of Panzer Force. Guess they have mostly planes besides these units here. So we'll send another Panzer there. Panzer 1. Oh, that's a Panzer 4. Let's send it towards their tank. And the Tiger 1 too. Tank will be totally outmatched. Alright, then the tactical bombers could also attack that tank unit. And then we have the fighter planes, they will attack their fighters, of course. Their MiG-3s here. They have more Yak-9s. Over there, they can't click on. Okay. And then we should have some planes over here as well. There. Okay, we're done. Start the battle.
Good. So can be mapping turn.
Tanks are moving forward. And the planes. Slaughtered the infantry and the tanks as expected. Their planes are still a threat, and they had some new troops also arriving. MS-1 tanks here. Could send one of our Panzer Ones against their tanks. Maybe we should send both against them actually. Let's send Panzer 4 against that one. So the tank army could be moved towards their tanks actually. reception of the Panzer Ones. They should move towards the MS Ones there. So good. I wanted them to leave the battlefield of the planes. Attack their reinforcements over here. They have some planes here too. Balance of power is clearly on our side. 7% enemy skill, 5% ally skill, that's good. Better than expected. General Fallen, Captain Sergei, only a captain. Yeah. Captain leading the reinforcement troops. Yeah. That tank looked kind of bugged. Place these under AI control. So the pack forces are probably firing all the way from here.
Wir haben die feindliche Armee geschlagen. Jetzt ist es Zeit, die Schweine zu zerquetschen.
That unit seemed to be regrouping. Reforming. Battle is over. Step 7, let's continue then. Let's move them into the AI controlled force.
Das Reich hat seine Überlegenheit durch diesen Sieg bestätigt.
And we won the battle. Okay, clear victory! Gunter Alterbung had 399 men deployed, killed 306, an alright result. Men remaining 56, so that's good. The enemy armies were led by captains, Captain Sergei and Captain Ivan. And they killed only 50 men, 33. Alright. And we're done here. They attack with a smaller force. They left probably most of the invading army that invaded Brest inside of Brest, so they left most of the army inside of Brest out of the army that invaded. Alright. End of turn report. Still good in profit. City grows. Paris grows. Faction announcements. when a city grows, the population is probably increased. Faction announcements. Felix von Kutchler and Erwin Rommel. Alright. Chirurgeon. Excuse me. Chirurgeon improves the chances of casualties recovering from their wounds. Felix von Kutchler, linguist, +2 to influence, improves negotiation skills. Construction report. We have civil headquarters in Berlin and in Amsterdam we have an SS headquarters. Right, recruitment report. We have a Tiger 1 in Berlin and in Vienna, Copenhagen and Oslo we have some assault infantry. So our army, we are very victorious over here. Not the right type of army to attack a city. We have 3 units of MiG-3s here. And they decided to stand their ground. Let's overwrite the bug to say. Started to lag for some reason. Fuck it, locked itself up. Send only the air force against the city. No tanks. They have an army here too. Smaller force. They need to wait the turn.